Hello, good morning everyone. So friends, yesterday we have studied about the series. Now today we are going to take more functions of series. I hope you understood the series very well, as it contains homogeneous data, size is immutable, data values are mutable. So friends, let us go with the flow. Now today I am going to discuss two more functions which are very much of importance, as previously we have discussed in exercise also, that what are head and tail functions in series. What are head and tail functions in series? Now first, what I have to do? Yes, I have to import pandas. If I want to write as pandas as pd1, as it is okay. Now taking s is equal to pd1 dot capital S series, there is a list of values corresponding to them I have given index. Now if I want to take head, it means first three values, and it means if I will take this, it means last three values. Now let me run this program for you. Right, this is our output. Now for head, I will see for head. Now three values, index A corresponds to value 1, B corresponds to value 2, C corresponds to value 3. These are the three values which have to be taken. Now look, A is equal to 1, 2 and 3, D type is equal to 64. Now take a look at the tail part. Now tail starts last three values, C, D, E. So C corresponds to 3, D corresponds to 4, E corresponds to 5. Now friends, we have to, so what we are talking about is head and tail. So head will take out all the these first three values, and tail will take out the next three values. Now moving on to the next program, how would you retrieve? Retrieving data means you will get the values, whatever you want. You want the values from the series. Now if I want all the data, then I should write for the values or from the head and tail. Now I want my data of some specific indexes that I have done. For example, if I want to take index A, B, C, D, E, then I have to take index C and D. How can I write? I will write like this. First take braces and then this. Let me run it for you first. It is taking a little bit of time, but it will run. Don't worry. Now after taking the answer, what we have to do, we have to put C and D here. Now what will happen, look at the output, C and D will be here with their corresponding values. Now what will happen if I will just, instead of this, I will remove C and D. Now let's look at the answer. It is an invalid syntax. Now if I will write only C, then what will happen? We have to look after each and every case. Whatever we are having, it will print the series. Now let us see. It will print. It is taking somewhat time today. Now it will print the value. Okay, now these are the values. So I am redoing it. Whatever we have done, I am redoing it. Now I will change the index value from this to this. Now let us look at the answer. Friends, we are doing that we can retrieve data using this labels, right? Now first the data of E will come, then the data of A will come. Now E is 5, A is 1. E is 5, A is 1. So in this way you can retrieve data from a series using labels. This is very much important, because slicing is as important in each and everything we are doing. So you must be trained about it, right? Now let me come to the next part, use of location and index location. Now import pandas as pd, import numpy as np, s is equal to pd dot series, np dot nan. Now friends, what I have created, I have created an array with not a number. Size means there are no elements corresponding to these 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, whatever the given indexes are, there are no values corresponding to it. Now let me show you two functions by integer. It will look for data by integer and as per the label, or look for the data by label. These are two things. So if I will run them, let us look at how they are different in their working. Now let me look. It is taking some time today to run. Yes. Okay. Now if I will go for LOC. Now first LOC. Okay. Three values are there up to index 3. 0, 1, 2. This is 0. This is 1. And this is 2. So for 0, 1, 2, it has given values N, A, N, not a number. Now for this LOC. LOC means up to label 3. So up to label 3 is this. 4 and 5 are left. So let us look at the example. 449 is NaN for ILOC. 48 NaN, not a number, not a number. Look, it has taken up to this. Now friends, have a look at this type. Float is equal to 64, because by default NaN is a non-decimal part. So it will make the whole question, as we have studied earlier, that 2DFs are in integer values, and when we add them, why it is taken to the floating point or the non-decimal type? Because we are having NaN, which is a non-decimal value. Now friends, I think ILOC and LOC are clear. Now let me move to the next. Oh, we have started data frames. Now before starting on data frames, let me remind of you what are data frames. Now data frames are 2D like structure, 2D array like structure that contains heterogeneous data, means different kind of data, different kind of data can be put into a collection as data frames. Now as data frames are there, what we have to do next? We have to do look for the some features which are sizes immutable. We can add or delete number of rows and columns that we will see further in our programming and theoretical part we have done. And also there are column additions we can take place. So size is immutable, also data values are immutable. So let me first start with creating an empty data frame. Empty data frame. Now first thing we have to do is import pandas as pd1. I have imported pandas as pd1. Now I have taken a data frame called df1 is equal to pd dot data frame. Now friends, look at the thing that D is capital and F is capital. So D is capital and F is capital, data frame. And I have taken it empty. So print df1. df1 is my answer. Right? Now, if I will move further with data frame as list, there are 5 methods. Now, as we know that we can create data frame using 5 methods. Number 1 is list. Number 2 is ND array. Number 3 is dictionary. Number 4 data frame itself, and number 5 is from the this series. Now first we will start with creating a data frame with list. So for that, first we have to define a list. This is our list. Data 1 is equal to 1 2 3 4 5, right? And now df1 is equal to pd1 dot data frame, data 1, print df1. Now what will happen if I run this? Oh, let us wait for the answer. Okay, now this is our answer. Index number 0 goes for 1, index number 1 goes for 2, index number 2 goes for 3, index number 3 goes for 4, index number 4 goes for 5. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So all the 5 values are there and 4 indexes are there. Now let me move to the next question. How can we create a data from list in a different way? Now I have created a list in which there is a name, suppose Freya, Mohak, Dvedi, and there are some values as their indexes, or their some other values are there. Now if I have to represent this value, I can give the name of the columns if I am having 2D structure. Now columns can be given within the this columns is equal to name comma age, and print df1. Now let it run for you. What output we will get will be in front of us. Now our output will be that the column names will be written over it, and then the age column. Look, names are Freya, Mohak. Now it will assume as name is Freya, second is Mohak, third is Dwedi. Now here age is 10, 12 and 13. So it will be 0, 1, 2, indexes will be same. The values will change only, the indexes will be same, right? So let me move on to next one. It is also from the dictionaries of ND arrays. Now what I have done, I have put those data of Mohak, Freya, etc. into the dictionary. Now what is the symbol of dictionary to start? A curly brackets. Name is equal to, I have taken two names, Freya, Mohak, and age 9, 10. So PD1.data frame, it is data 1, so it will be written as, I have given already column name. Now we have done the same thing as we have done by giving the values of the columns in the list. Now here I have maintained a dictionary, key values will become the name of the columns. Now let us run this and let us see what will be the value we can have in data frames using the dictionaries. Okay, so name is my first column, age is my second column, so keys will become our columns. Now instead of column, the first one is name. Name is, the values are Freya and Mohak, and age is there. In age we will have 9 and 10. So friends, we have already a look at the two methods of how to create two single thing from two methods. So number one is name and age, as you can take it as a dictionary, and the second method is you can take it as a list. So friends, keep this thing in mind and always remember there are two methods. You can use either, which you will find sufficient. Now from a list of dictionaries, now I have been given multiple dictionaries inside a list, means my dictionary is enclosed within a list. So x is 1, y is 2. Now here x is 5, y is 4 and z is 3. Now friends, have a look in the first column, in the first dictionary we don't have z. So if I will print my data frame as data 1, what will be the value? Now let us look at it. It will be in front of z, once it will be NAN. Now I am at, okay, look, now it is NAN and 5.0, because for z NAN is non-decimal value, so it will create a decimal value itself, so 5 will be converted to 5.0. friends, look at it, there I have made dictionaries within the list. So be careful about the braces. Whatever the braces you are using, it can be array, it can be list, it can be series, it can be data frames, it can be your dictionary, it can be your scalar quantity. So be particular about the braces you are using. So let me conclude with this thing, with this video. I am also attaching the video of your series which we have done. So friends, let us meet tomorrow. Thank you very much. Hello everyone, this is Tushar Agarwal, your IP teacher. So friends, we are discussing about Python pandas from past some few days regarding some theoretical aspects, regarding some practical aspects of Python pandas. We have studied so far series and data frames. Let us quick revision before going on to the practical of series and data frames. Let us first sort out what is series and what is data frame. Again, series is just like a 1D dimensional array structure which has homogeneous kind of data, size is immutable and data values are mutable. Whereas if I were to talk about on the other end about data frames, it is totally different. It is a 2D like structure which contains heterogeneous data. Heterogeneous means different types of data types can be collected at a single place, and size and data values are both mutable, means they can be changed at any point of time. Now before wasting any time further, now let us move to the practical of series. So I will first start with the series. Now first let us know that how a blank series can be created. Friends, as I told you that we have to use dot series function to do the series task. S is capital, Now we have to import a package called pandas first. Now let me show you how to do this. You have to go to tools, import shell. Now here you have to write pip install pandas. Now press enter. Now friends, while doing this, your system should be connected to the internet. Internet is compulsory. If I am having the file, just look at it. Let me show you what it goes. Okay, now requirement already satisfied because I am already installed pandas in it. Now if you will install it, it will just have an internet connection so that it can install it from the your package from the internet. So now after installing panda, we can use pandas as p-series, as pd, as whatever you want. Now first step is, first you have to install the pandas using the command pip install pandas. Now friends, I have written import pandas as p-series, s is equal to p-series dot series a blank. Now let us look at the output, how a empty series will come in the form of output. Look, there is a series. Now there are no elements in the series, it is shown. There are no elements in the series. Okay, now data type is float 64, then I have printed it. So friends, if any arises a question that you have to create a empty series, you can create this way. Now data type is by default float 64, as I told you. In Python, in numeric, it takes float by default. Now let me move to the next. Now friends, as we have studied that we can create a series using three ways. Number one, using your lists or using your ND arrays, we can say. Number two, using dictionary. Number three, using any scalar constant. So I am starting with the first one, that is create series using ND arrays, means array. Now friends, we can create a series using ND array using two methods. First one is with index and second one is without index. If with index or without index means that doesn't mean that memory location uses as index. That means that the index should be given by us, or we can say the label should be given by we people. Now import pandas as pd1, import numpy as np, as we have to create array, so we need numpy package. Now data is equal to numpy dot array. In braces I have written five elements, a, b, c, d. Now I have taken a series called s, pd1 dot series, bracket mein maine likh diya data, because data maine kya banaya, array. Here is array. Now let me run this for you. What is the output? We will just have a look. Let me take it up. Okay, now these are your index number. Now index number 0 lies within a, 1 to b, b to c, 3 to d. So friends, this is very important. Now if I will change the sequence of elements, that data values are my data values are mutable, so I will write here e and will run, so it will be e in place of this. Let me run this for you. Look, it is e. So we must keep in mind that the size is immutable, whereas the data is mutable. Now let me move to the next program with index. Now friends, this is very important as we are creating ND arrays with the help of index position. Now what do you mean by index position? That by index position, that doesn't mean that the memory location changes, only the name of the memory location changes. Now import pandas as pd, import numpy as np, data is equal to np1 dot array abcd. Now friends, as we have declared data, we can also write it as, suppose I will cut it and do one thing, make a list. And here we write list. It is the same. Now we have to check, can we do this thing with this? Okay, what I will do, I will cut. I will just take it list 1 is equal to, then paste it. Index is equal to list 1. Now let us see what happens. Look, these all things are similar. You can try in any way. Now 100 corresponds to A, 102 corresponds to B, 102 corresponds to C, and 103 corresponds to So where it doesn't matter whether you declare your list or you declare your data, it depends on the correct syntax. The number of elements should be equal to the number of indexes. Now I have taken a thing, if I will write one more index space, I will write 104. Now let us see what will happen, whether there will be output error, because there are 4 and in fact we have taken 5, so it will be an error. We, as the number of elements are there, we have to take same in the index. Now this is how we can create array using, we can create series using array. This is with index, without index, that we don't have to give any indexes, we just have to give any values, either simply or the other way. And the second method is, we will give with the help of index. We can mention any index value, whether it will be the, whether it will be a form of some string, some integer, or some any other value. Now let me move to the second part, that how can we create series using dictionaries. Now friends, dictionaries are a very important part, as you all know how to write it. Now there are only two aspects, as in the test, that there should be a index or there should not be any index. Now first, how to create a dictionary. This curly brackets are taken, this is a key, this corresponds to the value. Now there can be more than one value for a particular key, but these key values cannot be duplicated. Then same pd1.series, in braces I have written data. Now let it be run for you. Now look at the answers. Now labels act as the keys, act as the index number. This is the question which I have told you, how to specify index values in the data frame or in a series. Now friends, this is dictionary. I have told you the dictionary does not contain duplicate keys. Now what if I made duplicate keys? Let us see whether there is an error or some value. Oh, it gives us value but only for 2. It means for the second duplicate, remember my words and listen carefully, it means for the second duplicate entry, it will not pick the value, it will pick the value or at the last occurrence it will have. Okay, now I will make it again and let it run for you. Friends, in this you have to take care while making a dictionary. If string values you have taken as keys, then you have to write quotes. If you are taking string values in the columns, you have to take columns. Okay, so next is your how we can create using dictionary with index. Now with index means import pandas as pd1, import numpy as np1, data is equal to dictionary. Now I have specified the sequence. Now the keys will be the only index in that. Now keys will be the only index in that. The thing is that I have made this jumble. Now if a key is comes to the first place, then I make it to the last place. If a key comes to the second place, I am. Now friends, remember one thing, that the values corresponding to the each key should remain same. The values corresponding to the each key should remain same. Now let me run it for you. After running it, we have found that, okay, now there is a key called D which does not have any value in the dictionary. So it will be applied as NaN, means not a number. What it denotes? It denotes not a number. Friends, when it comes to the not a number part, as discussed in the previous sessions, a question that if integer values are also there and not a number appears, then all the values will be converted to the non-decimal part, that is a floating point value. Now let me move to the next program, which is about creating from scalar. Scalar means any value we take. Now friends, this is a very easy method, as we want a single value to occupy all our indexes, whether we will specify any index or not. If we don't specify any index, let us see, if I will only write, then I will run it for you, whether it will be an error or it will run, you will see. Look, it will take only one index as 5. And if I will take this, there should be 5 at each and every holes. This is as simple. Now we have studied three methods: creating series using ND array, creating series with index, without index, creating series using dictionary with index, without index, and the last one using scalar. Now let us move to some mathematical operations over the series. Now import pandas as PD. I have made two using the list 1, 2, and 3, 1, 2, and 4. Now I have to implement addition operator and okay, now let it run for you. What it will show to you, let us see. Now look friends, it has cleared. First look at the addition part. Now the addition took place element by element. 1 is added to 1, 2 is added to 2, 4 is added to 3. So it will be 2, 0 at 2, 1 at 4, 7 at 3. Okay, right. Okay, these are the index numbers. Now if it comes to multiplication, element by element multiplication is taking place. Not just that, like matrix, each and every element should be multiplied by the each and every element. So taking this thing care of, we will multiply 1 into 1, 1, 0 index is 1, 1 index is 4, and 2 index is 12. Now if I want to apply any other operation on it, say I want to do u is equal to s minus t. And thank you. Now let us see what will happen. Look, 0 because 1 minus 1 is 0, 2 minus 2 is 0. Up now, whichever we write second will be subtracted from the first. So 3 minus 4 is 1. Instead, if I will write, I have to take positive values, then bigger will be first. So I will write t minus s. So t minus s will be, now let us see, t minus s will be 0, 0, 1. Same way. Now, these are the simple. Now, if I want to take the remainder, s percentage t. So what it will do, let us see. Print. Okay, now 0, 0, 3. Why it is 0, 0, 3? Because 1 by 1 leaves remainder 0, 2 by 2 leaves remainder 0, 3 by 4, now it is not divisible, so it will leave the remainder 3. Now friends, we have gone through the series part, that how empty series is created, how you can create various series using array, series using some dictionary or list or scalar quantity, how we can operate series using different functions. Now in the next session, I am going to tell you how you can access various values from a series using series data. Now friends, these are very important as data and all the analysis are integrated at a single place with the help of the memory locations. So it makes us very easy for us to understand the basics of data structures. So friends, I will meet you again with my next video on how you can access data series, how data frame can be made using various methods. Thank you.